Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today we are going to discuss two more questions which was asked in Optum. So first is, write the query to fetch all the employees who doesn't have department names in the department master table by using joins. So here, as we can see, we have two input tables. First is employee and second is department. In employee table, we have two columns. First is employee ID, then department ID. In the department master table, we have department ID and department name. So here we want to fetch those employees where department ID is not available in the department master table. But here we don't need to use the in operator or not exist. So we have to use join. So how we can write the query for getting this output? Let's move to SQL Server Management Studio, where we will write the query for getting this output. So as I am using SQL 2017, you may have another versions of SQL Server, but this query will work for all the versions. So first of all, I would like to execute the create table statement. So tables have been created successfully. First is employee table and second is department table. So now let me execute these two statements to insert data on the tables. So as you can see, four rows affected and four rows affected. So data have been loaded successfully into the tables. Next, we just need to check the data. So we can execute select asterisk from table. So as we can see here, we are having the same metadata as we seen in the slide. So how we can put join between these two tables for getting the output? So first of all, we want to get data from the employee table. So we can write select asterisk from, and here we can put the employee table. Then we need to use the left join. So, and then left join with department table. Now I need to put alias for employee as E and for department as D. On employee dot department ID should be equals to department dot department ID. Let me execute this query and check the output. So here, as we can see, we are getting the data, but here in the department table, we are getting the null values because those departments are not available in the department table. So we want to get only those employees. So here we can put where clause. So in where clause, D dot department ID is null. Now let me execute and we can check the output. So here we are getting only one row, that is four. So in the select statement, we want only two columns as we seen in the slide. So E dot employee ID, then D dot department name. Now let me execute and check the output. So as we can see, we are getting four and department name is null. So we can check, we are getting the same metadata. Next question is, here as we can see, we have two input tables. First is a student, second is employee contact. So in employee contact, we are having the phone numbers like mobile number and landline number. In student table, we are having four columns, student ID, name, date of birth and gender. As we can see in the output, we want all the data from the student table and we want the contact detail from the contact table. So here we need to write the query to select all the data from the student table along with the mobile number for each students. Contact numbers are mobile number or landline numbers. So if the type is M, then that is mobile number. If type is L, then that is landline number. In case if any student doesn't have mobile number, then select their landline number. So as we can see for the student 1, so he has only mobile number. So we need to display in the output. Second, for the student ID 2, he doesn't have mobile number. So in this case, we need to display the landline number. Next, for ID 3, she has mobile number as well as a landline number. So we need to display the mobile number only. Next, for ID 4, so she also has mobile number and landline number. So we need to display the mobile number. So as we can see in the output. So how we can write the query for getting this output? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio. And here, first of all, I would like to execute these two create statements to creating the tables, first for the student and second for the contact detail. So command completed successfully. So tables have been created. Now I just want to insert data on these two tables. So let me execute the insert statement. So as we can see, 4 rows affected and 6 rows affected. So 4 rows have been moved into student table and 6 rows into contact detail table. Now we can write the select statement and we can check the data. So we can write select asterisk from first student table and second contact detail table. So select asterisk from contact detail table. Now let me execute and check the output. So as we can see, here we are having the same metadata as we seen in the slide. So how we can implement the logic? So now let me copy the data of contact detail and go to on Excel to understand about the logic. So here paste that data and it should be number. Then here as we can see, if we will generate a sequence number, if we have mobile number, then that is 1. If we have landline number only, then 1. If we have mobile number and landline number, so first for the mobile number and second for the landline number. Then first for the mobile number and second for the landline number. We will apply filter where RW value equals to 1. Then we will get only that data which need to be displayed in the output. So as we can see, for the ID 1, we are having mobile number only. So mobile number in the output. For ID 2, we have only landline number, so that is going to display in the output. For ID 3 and 4, these two has mobile number as well as landline number, so we need to display only mobile number. So if we will generate a sequence number like this, then we can simply apply filter and we can get the output. So how we can write the query? So here, first of all, we need to create a sequence number for this contact detail table. So we can use the row number, then we can use the OR clause, then we have to use the partition by, and partition by on student ID. Then we have to use the order by clause, and order by should be on type in decreasing order. Now we can use as RW. Now let me execute this query and check the output. So as we can see, we are getting 1 for mobile number 1 and landline number 2. Mobile number 1, landline number 2. If we will apply filter on this, then I hope we will get the output. So how we can write the query and we can get the output? So here let me call this as A, then use the inner join or left join and put this into a derived table and call that table as B. Then on A dot student ID should be equals to B dot student ID and B dot RW value should be equals to 1 as we seen in the Excel. Now let me execute this query and check the output. So I guess we are getting the output as we were expected. So here we want all the columns from the employee table and we just want the phone number from the contact detail table. So now let me execute the query and we can compare the output. So we are getting the data as we were expected. So I hope you have understood how to write these two queries for getting the outputs. In the next video, we will discuss few more questions which was asked in Optum. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. If you need this script, it will be available on the description of this video, so you can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.